Good morning, children. Today, in surface areas and volume, part 5, we are going to study about the volume of a cylinder and cone. In the previous slide, we have already learned about the total surface area and the curved surface area of a cylinder and cone. Now, let us study the volume of a cylinder, which we have learned in class 8. Which is base area into height. We know the base of the cylinder is circle in shape and area of a circle is pi r square. Let h be the height of the cylinder. Therefore, we can say volume of a cylinder is equal to pi r square h. For finding the volume of a cone, we can find a relation between volume of the cone and the cylinder. For that, take a hollow cylinder and a hollow cone with the same radius and the same height. Fill the cone up to the brim with sand once and empty it into the cylinder. We can see the cylinder is not full. Repeat the same process till we can see the cylinder is full. Here we come to see that when the cone is filled up for 3 times, the cylinder is full. From this we can say volume of a cylinder is equal to 3 times the volume of a cone. Or from this we can say volume of a cone is 1/3 volume of a cylinder, which we can write it as 1 by 3 pi r square h, where h is the height and r is the radius. Exercise 13.6 in page number 230. Question number 1. The circumference of the base of a cylindrical vessel is 132 cm and its height is 25 cm. How many liters of water can it hold? We are given a relation 1000 cm cube is equal to 1 liter. Because our question is to find how much liters of water can it hold, but when we find the volume as the unit is in centimeter, we will be getting the answer in centimeter cube. And from that we have to convert it into liters. So in our question we are given height is equal to 25 cm and circumference of the base is 132 cm. We know for a cylinder the base is circle in shape. So what is the circumference of a circle? It is 2 pi r. Substituting we can say 2 pi r is equal to 132 cm. From this, we can find the radius of the cylindrical vessel. 2 into 22 by 7 into r is 132. Transposing 2 and 22 by 7 to the right hand side, we can find radius. R is equal to 132 into 7 by 44. Cancelling, we can see radius is equal to 21 cm. Now let us find the volume of the vessel. Volume of the vessel we can say it is pi r square h, 22 by 7 into 21 square into 25. After cancellation we come to an answer with 34,650 centimeter cube. To find the answer in terms of liter, we are given 1000 centimeter cube is 1 liter. So divide 34,650 by 1000 and our answer is 34.65 liters. Question number 2. The inner diameter of a cylindrical wooden pipe is 24 cm and its outer diameter is 28 cm. We can imagine a pipe with some thickness. Therefore, we are having two types of radius. One is inner radius and one is the outer radius. We are given the length of the pipe is 35 cm. Find the mass of the pipe. If 1 cm cube of wood has a mass of 0.6 gram. We can see the inner diameter is 24. Therefore, inner radius, which is taken as small letter r, will be 12 cm. Outer diameter is given as 28 cm. Therefore, outer diameter 28 divided by 2, which will be the outer radius, is 14 cm. The height of the pipe is given as 35 cm. To find the volume of the pipe, we can say volume of the outer cylinder minus volume of the inner cylinder. We can substitute the formula pi capital R square H minus pi small r square h. Seeing pi and h as common, we can write that as pi into capital R square minus small r square multiplied with height. Substituting the values, it will be 22 by 7 into 14 square minus 12 square multiplied with 35. Our answer will be 5720 centimeter cube. We are given that 1 centimeter cube of wood will have a mass of 0.6 gram. Therefore, 5720 centimeter cube of wood will have 0.6 into 5720, which is 3432 gram. When it is converted into kilogram, we can say 3.432 kilogram of mass. Question number 4. If the lateral surface of a cylinder is 94.2 centimeter square and its height is 5 cm, then find radius of its base and volume of the cylinder. Here we are asked to take the value of pi as 3.14. We are given lateral surface area is 94.2. We are given lateral surface area means we can substitute the formula for the lateral surface area of a cylinder. That is 2 pi rh is equal to 94.2. We are given height also, which is equal to 5 cm. That means substituting 2 into 3.14 into r into 5 is equal to 94.2. Multiplying 2 into 5, 10 into 3.14, it will be 31.4. Therefore, radius is equal to 94.2 by 31.4, which is 3 cm. Once we are able to find the radius, we can find volume of the cylinder, pi r square h, 3.14 into 3 square into 5, which is equal to 141.3 cm cube. Question number 5. It cost 2200 rupees to paint the inner curved surface of a cylindrical vessel 10 meter deep. If the cost of painting is at the rate of rupees 20 per meter square, find inner curved surface area of the vessel, radius of the base, capacity of the vessel. We are given the total cost of painting as 2200 rupees. How can we find the total cost of painting? It will be the area multiplied with the rate per meter square. So we can write that 2200 rupees as the inner curved surface area, that is CSA, multiplied with how much rate is there for 1 meter square, which gives 2200 rupees. We are given for 1 meter square it is 20 rupees. So substituting that value, CSA into 20 rupees is totally 2200 rupees. From this we can find inner curved surface area equal to 2200 divided by 20, which is equal to 110 meter square. So we got the answer, the inner curved surface area of the vessel is 110 meter square. As we know the curved surface area, we can substitute the formula 2 pi rh is equal to 110. We are given the height of the vessel as 10 meter. Substituting 2 into 22 by 7 into r into 10 is equal to 110. We can find radius as 7 by 4 or 1.125 meter. For finding the capacity of the vessel, we can use volume, which is pi r square h, 22 by 7 into 7 by 4 whole square into 10. And our answer is 96.25 meter cube. We know 1 meter cube is 1000 liter. This 1000 liter is also written as 1 kiloliter. Therefore, we can say 1 meter cube is equal to 1 kiloliter. So 96.25 meter cube is the same as 96.25 kiloliters. Question number 6. The capacity of a closed cylindrical vessel of height 1 meter is 15.4 liters. How many square meters of metal sheet would be needed to make it? We are given height of the vessel is 1 meter and the capacity of the vessel is 15.4 liter. We need to convert that liters into meter cube. We know 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. Therefore, 15.4 liter is equal to 15.4 divided by 1000, which is 0.0154 meter cube. We know the formula for capacity of the vessel, which is pi r square h, is equal to 0.0154. That is 22 by 7 into r square into height 1 is equal to 0.0154. From this we can find r square, which is 0.0154 multiplied with 7 divided by 22, and our answer is 0.0049. To find radius, we need to find the square root of this, and our answer will be 0.07 meter. Therefore, radius of the vessel is 0.07 meter, height of the vessel is 1 meter. To make this vessel, how much square meters of metal sheet is required? That means total surface area of the cylindrical vessel, which is 2 pi r into r plus h. 2 into 22 by 7 into 0.07 multiplied with 0.07 plus 1, and our answer will be 0.4708 meter square. Question number 7. A lead pencil consists of a cylinder of wood with a solid cylinder of graphite filled in the interior. The diameter of the pencil is 7 mm and diameter of the graphite is 1 mm. If the length of the pencil is 14 cm, find the columns of the wood and that of the graphite. We all are familiar with a pencil, where it consists of wood as well as the graphite, which we use for writing. We are given height of the graphite is 14 cm, which also can be written as 140 mm. Let us find the graphite, how much is the volume. Diameter of the graphite is 1 mm, therefore radius will be 1 divided by 2, which is equal to 0.5 mm. Therefore, volume of the graphite will be pi r square h, that is 22 by 7 into 0.5 whole square into 140, which is equal to 110 millimeter cube. Now, for finding the volume of the wood, first let us find the full volume of the pencil. Volume of the pencil means it includes the wood as well as the graphite. Diameter of the pencil is given as 7 mm, therefore radius will be 3.5 mm. Volume of the pencil is pi r square h, which is 22 by 7 into 3.5 square into 140, and our answer is 5390 mm cube. From this we can find the volume of the wood, which is volume of the full pencil minus volume of the graphite. That is 5390 minus 110, which is 5280 millimeter cube. To convert that into centimeter cube, we can write it as 5.28 centimeter cube. The questions number 3 and 8 is familiar questions, and you can try to do those two questions as a homework.